Each year, selected homeowners across Clark County open their gardens to the public. These gardens showcase some of the best examples of natural gardening in our region. The gardens thrive without the use of chemical pesticides or fertilizers for the benefit of wildlife, waterways, and community health. Let's take a tour of some of the most beautiful natural gardens in Clark County.
This is a totally organic garden. I'm taking care of this land. I may own it now, but I don't really own it. It's just important to me that people, critters be safe, that my pollinators have lots of places to go. So I feel like I'm a very big contributing member to a good environment. Hi, I'm Vanessa Gardner-Nagel. Welcome to my garden, Dragonfly Hollow. I've been gardening for over 50 years, so I've learned a lot of different things, what not to do and what to do. So here, it's very important. First of all, we use no pesticides, no herbicides. We make sure that any fertilizers are organic, and that usually means that the NPK number doesn't exceed 20, for example. And I also do my research when I am selecting a plant for, say, a wet, sunny area. I want to make sure that the plant has the best chance to start off. I'm not going to put a dry shade plant in a wet, sunny area. And so that takes research. You have to look it up. I plant intensely. So some people might look at it and say, did you save any space for soil? And in fact, because I don't like to weed, this is the best practice for minimizing weeds, because if I plant it, Mother Nature's not. We love our birds here. I try to give them places to go. But I also have plants that are very high pollinator plants, and some that most people don't know, and so they're kind of unusual. But just because it's not a native plant doesn't mean it can't be a really good plant for a garden. And it's just a matter of paying attention to its needs, where it comes from, knowing that it's not going to be invasive, and that it's gonna do the job you're setting it out to do. I mean, there's so many things that you could tell a new garden, and I wouldn't want to should all over them, but I think that the biggest, most important thing is to educate yourself. So if you really are interested in gardening, you wind up being intellectually curious. And I think that's a trait that will serve you well if you want to succeed at gardening.
Do you want to be a part of the Clark Green Neighbors Garden Tours? For more information, please visit www.clarkgreenneighbors.org/garden tour.